after session. So I can go on my rant mode now. Yay! Okay.
Yes, you can have your rant, which we should preface this by saying this is specifically a rant about the cosplay contest at ANT and cosplayers on stage.
I do want to say, though, that in this past year, since I've taken a step back from doing runway myself and have just been up front doing press things, it's not just at ANT that this happens. This happens at so many cons, and it just kills me.
It does.
It kills me.
It happened to be rather blatant.
Oh, yeah. That one was just like...
Especially at ANT.
Oh, yeah. It was rampant amongst the beginners all the way up to the masters. So it's not like it was just one class. No, it was everybody.
Yes.
So here is my rant. And this is the reason why I started doing my cosplay runway panel, because I think it's important for people to know this. When you walk up on that stage, it is your time to shine. It is your time to show the world, I made this kick-ass costume, look at me. In doing so, you need to stand still so people can take your photo, people can take video of you, the judges can admire your lovely, lovely work. And then you can move. Now, when I say stand still, I mean you stand still for a good 8 to 10 seconds when you count in your head. Because when you count 8 to 10 seconds in your head, it's actually counting a lot faster. So realistically, you're only standing about 5 seconds still. But that's enough time for photographers, for videographers, for your friends, for your family, for your loved ones, for your judges to see your wonderful, wonderful work before you move on to the next position. It was so horrible to see so many people go up on that stage, maybe stand still for 1 second if you were lucky, and then
maybe
move to, if you were lucky, yeah, and then move to the next spot. And then they twirl around and move to the third spot, and they immediately walked off stage because they didn't stand at that third spot long enough to get captured. And it was
a lot of people only did two poses.
Yeah.
I mean, there wasn't even an attempt at a third. They just did two and then walked off stage.
Yeah, even, and I'm not going to say which one this is, but there was one where he did a great job when he stayed at the first and the second position. The second position, he held it for a good 8 seconds, and he got a great crowd reaction. But when he went to the third spot, he stood there for half a second and then immediately started walking off. And I was like, no, buddy, I could have gotten one more picture of you. And
right.
The reason that I bring this up is that because I was up front taking photographs, so I was the one crawling on the ground trying to get a photo of everybody, and if you guys have watched us long enough to know that Amber and I tried to give every cosplayer who's on that runway a chance to shine.
They're due.
Yeah, we want to make sure all of them are in the video, all of them have at least a photo up. I could not do that this time. There were so many people walking by so fast that it was a lot of blurs on my camera, and that made me want to cry. Here's the thing. Photoshop is fantastic. Photoshop will help you get rid of your zits, will help you get rid of the blackness under your eyes, will make you look 10 years younger. It cannot get rid of blurs.
Right.
Photoshop, no program, no image program out there will get rid of motion. So if you move when that photo is snapped, you're lost. And I had so many blurred photos that I was just like, I'm so sorry. I can't post this. And
right.
This is something that I was talking about with Amber, and I don't know if we discussed this in the car or if we did this via email, but one thing that I want to do for my future runway panels is to either A, show the photos that I've taken over the years of people being blurry cosplayers so people can actually see, oh, so that's what it looks like when I don't stop. That's what it looks like when I'm moving too fast on the stage. I should probably stop. Or to do a live demonstration either with someone taking like photos of me or like doing a video of me as I'm walking like a person normally would walk and stand and pose, but you know, much faster than I really should be. And so they can see the immediate aftermath, like, oh, now I get it. Because I don't think people quite understand because they haven't seen it. And especially when it comes to the runway, it's like that's a guarantee that you get at least one photo of your costume. Even if nobody takes a photo of you throughout the rest of the day, you're guaranteed one by going to the contest. And if you can't find that one of yourself, it probably means you didn't stand still long enough. And I don't think people are aware of that. So, yeah, that's a portion of my rant. It's just stand still for 8 to 10 seconds. Count it off in your head. 1, Mississippi. 2, Mississippi. 3, Mississippi. You don't even have to say the Mississippi part. If you do 1, 2, three, four, five. That's already like 3 seconds right there. Because again, you count faster normally in your head than you do on a watch. But that'll give you plenty of time to stand still, to present yourself, and people will see your awesome, awesome work. Because that's the whole point. Show yourself off. Show yourself off with pride and let people take pictures of you. Dang it.
I would have two things to add. The one is that as a cosplayer, you need to understand from the photographer's point of view that as you walk across a stage, we are waiting for you to stop. We want you to stop because we know that that means you're going to at least be still for a moment, and then we can get ready to press the trigger, because there's no sense in pressing the trigger on a camera if you're moving. It's going to get a blurry shot every time. We want you to stop so that we get a still photo. So as soon as we see you stop, we kind of have to wait a second to make sure you're actually going to stay there long enough to get a good photo. So it takes about one full second after you've stopped for us to actually press the trigger and get a photo, which means you need to stand still long enough for us to actually realize, yeah, we can take the picture now. You're not going to suddenly move on us. Hence, that's why we always say count to five or count to eight, is because photographers kind of have to wait a second to kind of time their shot and make sure you're going to look good. It takes us a second. Photos aren't instant. Mm-mm. If you want good photos, they're not instant.
They're definitely not instant.
I mean, experienced photographers can kind of guess where and when you're going to stop, and we can actually hit the trigger. And sometimes we guess right. Sometimes we get a fantastic photo that way. Sometimes we guess wrong and you move anyway, and then you get a blur. So there's less guesswork if you actually just stand there and don't move for at least 5 seconds to give us time to get the shot where we want it, and then move. And that means stand still. It does not mean, you know, move your arm up. It doesn't mean swing your sword. You know, it means you actually have to stay still, because any movement creates blur in a photo. Even if you're swinging a sword, if you have a staff and you're whirling it around, that's movement. You can't have that in a photo. Video's fine. Video, you move as much as you want.
And actually, what I would recommend to people is, as you're making that transition from point one to point two or point two to point three, when you are moving, that's a great time to move your props. That's a great time to twirl that staff or to do that cool sword move, because then you can move yourself into that next position, hold it, and you're still cool looking and badass.
Right. So you're still showing off your costume for the judges, but you're also giving the photographer something to work with. The second thing I wanted to add is that while showing the back of your costume is a good thing for judges, don't show photographers the back of your costume.
Don't do it unless it's an awesome, awesome, awesome back piece. Like if
Zelda was an exception, because she actually had embroidery and things on the back of her costume.
Mm-hmm.
But you can still show that while moving from pose one to pose two. You can show the back in movement. Don't pose with your back to the camera unless that is completely purposeful, because otherwise we miss the vast majority of your costume and your face, which is what we want to see.
Yeah, I have a good picture of this where I did it with my Jean costume, because she has this back piece that I fully hand embroidered, and a lot of what makes her costume stand out from the other characters is the fact that that back piece is so stunning. So when I did my move, I did show my back to the audience, but I cheated myself out enough that I could still tuck my head over my shoulder so people could still see my face.
Right,
so
you want a three-quarter position, not
exactly,
a full back position.
Not a full back position. So you got to learn how to move and cheat your body out so the audience can still see the moneymaker, your face.
Right, and I say this because there were at least two cosplayers who posed with their back fully to the audience. And to be honest, the back of their costume had nothing interesting going for it. There was no movement, no embroidery, no painting. There was absolutely nothing, and it's like, just, you know, do a three-quarter so we can at least see part of you and get a better shot. If you want to shoot full back to the audience in a photo shoot with background, like I know there's a whole superhero thing where you're looking over your back shoulder, that's cool. Photo shoots are cool. Not during a cosplay contest. You don't
definitely
want that to be
contest.
One of your photographs. Yeah.
Mm.
It doesn't do your costume or you any justice to pose like that.
And the only time it's acceptable is if you have something amazing on your back. Even then, I'd still rather that you cheat your face so I can see your eyes.
Yep. Give us a three-quarter.
Give us three-quarter. Ah! Rants from the photographer position. It amazes me that as long as cosplay contests have been around, one, that there's very few people who actually do runway panels. Like, there's myself, there's another girl that I know in California who does it, and then SCCC does it, and they do a great job at it. So it's like, I'm glad that there are those of us who want to impart our wisdom. At the same time, it's kind of funny that it's been going on for so long, and like I said, master-level cosplayers still make the same mistakes. There are so many that I know and I've judged before where they'll be on stage, they'll stand in their spot for 2 seconds, move to the next spot, and it's like, whoa, okay, bye, hi, bye.
It's longer than you think. It really is longer than you think it is. Mm-hmm. You get a full 30 seconds to walk across that stage.
30 seconds is a long time.
It really is. It really is. And you'll stand there, and you'll see all the flashes going off in the audience, and then you'll think, okay, it's time to move now. Nope.
That means you
still gotta wait.
And I know that some of it is nerves, especially, I mean, even I will get nervous sometimes. I'm not afraid to admit that. A lot of it is just taking deep breaths, and the best thing that you can possibly do is just keep counting in your head. Focus on what you're counting in your head. Because if you've done everything you should have been doing, you know, you've practiced at home what your moves are going to be, you know how you're going to pose, and you even adjusted for, now that you've seen the stage, you've adjusted for it. Just practice on counting in your head, and that'll help you hold your poses a little bit longer.
And don't feel like the announcer is pushing you along either.
I mean, just
because they talk fast or because they may sound like they're finishing up, you're not obligated to move yourself faster. You have 30 seconds.
Use those 30 seconds. Just make the best of it. Dang it. Again.
Right.
You did kick-ass work. You want people to see it. So strut your stuff and stand up there. Dang it.
Plus, I mean, think about it this way. If you were not prejudged and everything's getting judged on stage, wouldn't you want to give the judges the maximum amount of time to see everything about your costume instead of having it judged in 8 seconds?
You better believe when AllCon comes around and I do my Amidala thing, I am standing there. I might twirl once, but I don't even think I'll do that. I'm going to look pretty as possible, and I'm holding it.
Yeah, I mean, the judges are literally judging you on the spot as you walk. Mm-hmm. So you want them to have the full 30 seconds to deliberate and see everything there is to see about your costume.
Exactly.
And that's also why it's a good idea to move slowly.
Yes.
And then stand still in your poses so that they have a chance to see it and the judges aren't judging a blur. Because if they see a blur, they're going to judge a blur and you're not going to get any points.
What a photographer sees is what a cameraman sees. What a cameraman sees, the audience sees. What the audience sees is what the judges see. If all four of them see blurs, or any
That's
one of them
judging.
See a blur, everybody's seeing the blur. So,
yep.
Yeah,
I mean, we're not doing this to rant. We're doing it because we want cosplayers to have their due.
Exactly. That's what kills me the most. It's like, I see all this beautiful, beautiful work, and to see it get rushed across the stage, it's just, it makes me sad. I was like, I want people to see this cool stuff you did, and you're not taking the time. It's almost like you're doing a disservice to yourself by not standing up there and letting people take your photo. Like, you earned that right. You've made that awesome costume. You earned the right to be up there. Let us take your picture, dang it. Stand still. Don't move.
Yeah. I haven't found a single person who doesn't want a picture of their costume that is a
exactly.
good picture. I mean, after a con, you go to the forums and everybody's like, okay, so did anybody take a picture of my costume? Did anybody see this person?
Mm-hmm.
Well, yeah, we saw them. And we have a picture of you, but you didn't stop and sit still long enough for us to get a good picture of you.
Mm-hmm.
People, most of the time, want good photos of their costume, if nothing else, for their portfolio. Because you'll notice that people may not necessarily have their own photographs of their cosplay. They depend on photographers to help supply them with portfolio pictures, which is fine if you have permission. Most photographers are okay with it if it's for a non-commercial purpose, like a portfolio. So the more quality pictures you have of your cosplay, the more choice you have for, you know, building a nice portfolio.
Exactly. It just makes my heart sad. And I just hope that, I really do hope that of all the panels that I submitted to AECON, because my preference was the runway panel, I would love to teach that again, especially at AECON. I don't think that there was one last year, so I think if I can get it this year on a Friday or a Saturday, it would be fantastically fun. And I want to make it fun. And that's just one of my favorite things to be teaching.
See, I am doing prop making, electronics, and mold making. That's one panel.
I'm going to try
It's
to
going to
help
be
you
a
out with molding.
monster of a panel.
Oh my goodness.
And
3 hours
then
later.
when. No, two hours is the most I could ask for.
Okay.
I think for that one, I went 1.5 hours.
Good call. Good call.
And then I'm doing one on armor building, power tools, and Pepakura. That's one panel. That's my 2 hour panel. And then I'm doing the advanced sewing techniques one.
Yeah.
And I think I asked for 1 hour on that one because it's not going to take that long to demonstrate sewing.
I say, and I noticed that your call out to other cosplayers to help teach panels has done pretty well because I've seen a couple people have written back to me saying, "Yeah, I've submitted this panel," and, or "I submitted this panel."
Woo!
Some of them have, I know some people have asked me, you know, "Can you help me out with mine?" Let me see what Akon accepts first.
I was going to say, I mean, even if we can't help you, which, to a point, we can assist on other panels, but bear in
Oh, yeah.
mind that we're also at Akon as press, so we have certain press duties that we have to cover in addition to teaching our own panel. So if we say that we can't help you, it's not because we don't like you. We love you all, but we only have so much time as human beings at Akon, and occasionally we need a break too. We need to be able to eat and take care of our own health because otherwise we won't make it through Akon.
And we have a cosplay contest.
And we have a cosplay contest we are
I
entering in. We will both be on stage next year.
can't believe we're doing that, but that's
So
so
there
awesome.
is that to be said. But yes, we highly encourage those of you that would like to submit a panel to Akon,
Do it.
please do, because we would like to give them the best cosplay track in the country. That would be fantastic.
That would be awesome.
And I mean, even if you need help maybe writing an outline for your panel, we can help with that.
Oh yeah, we
Even if we
Amber.
can't be there for you at Akon, we can still help you do prep work. I mean, we can peer review what you've got if you would like.
Or if we're too busy, we know other cosplayers that know stuff about that subject. We can direct you their way. I mean, heck, that's what we're here for.
It's one of the great things about having a podcast is we have connections.
Oh
So if
yeah.
you need to get in touch with somebody who is really good at a particular thing, we can point you to them.
Absolutely.
The worst they'll say is, "No, I'm sorry, I can't help you at Akon." But that doesn't mean they can't help in other ways, like maybe pointing you to certain resources you didn't know about. So there's always that. So yes, we highly encourage you guys, go ahead and submit your panels to Akon. Worst they'll tell you is no, but most of the time they'll probably tell you yes. Especially since they're basically going to be a Fort Akon next year.
Pretty much.
They're not officially a Fort Akon,
But they're
more
kind
or
of
less
leaning
they're a Fort Akon.
towards it.
Yeah. They have programming on Thursday now. They're a Fort Akon.
They're 4 day or 3.5 day.
Yes, and if work allows it, I am going to try and be there all day Thursday.
Oh,
Not
I
just
know I
get there
won't.
after work on Thursday. I want to take Thursday off of work. In fact, I want Thursday, Friday, and Monday off of work if I can manage it.
I wish I could do that. I know I can't.
Well, if I have to pick my days wisely and they're willing to give them to me, then I'm going to ask for what I want. I'm not going to sit there and mess around with it because I have
Yeah.
limited days.
Having that
But
Monday off after Akon really
is a
helps.
massive help. Oh my
Oh my
gosh. I never
goodness.
get to take that Monday. I never do because of where it falls during the month. But next year it's a week later. So I may actually be able to get that Monday. But I also have to consider the fact that, yeah, I have 8 symphony concerts throughout the year, and I don't think they're going to let me take partial days. I think they're going to make me take full days, and that means I have 8 days out of my schedule already gone. Let's see, 8 days for Symphony, 3 days for Akon, 2 days for Alcon. That only leaves 2 days, and then I've used up all the PTO I have for the year. So 1 day for TRF and 1 day for San Japan. That's it. I'm gone. Now I have no sick. Now I have no sick days.
You have no sick days, so don't get sick.
I can't ever get sick. I'll have to go to work sick the whole time.
Okay. Everybody else does it. Why don't you?
No, I don't really want to do that. I may see if they'll let me flex just a bit for Symphony, because that would really help. I need the extra money
And
and the experience.
experience.
I need to keep playing my instrument. That way, my degree is good for something.
Yay!
Yeah, my degree is actually in orchestral performance, so.
Mine's still sitting in my tube.
Had to frame mine because it took me quite a bit of work to get that, incidentally.
Oh no, I love the one that they gave me at graduation at Baylor. It was the people who got like like cum laude, summa cum laude, like all the high honors, they didn't have everything printed in time. So basically they gave me a sheet of paper that says that your diploma will be delivered in 4 weeks.
Nice.
I framed that one. I was like, this is great. This is what I got for my $80,000. Go me!
Yeah, I graduated cum laude, but I also wasn't giving full effort. See, if I were to get a degree at college right now, I would be, was it magna cum laude?
Mm-hmm.
It's the highest one, I think.
No, summa cum laude.
Summa is the most? Okay. I would graduate summa cum laude.
Yeah, I did.
Which doesn't really mean much anymore.
No, it really doesn't.
It really doesn't, because right now I have a perfect 4.0, and does it mean anything? No.
No.
I still haven't gotten any scholarship offers. Come
we're
on.
Old farts.
Man, I am a woman in IT with a perfect grade point average trying to work in security. How does that not merit automatic full scholarship, man?
I have so many things I could say, but I don't want to say them because we might get in trouble.
No, please don't get us in trouble.
I'll do it in chat session so nobody else can see it.
Yeah.
There you go. There are your reasons. I have been told those exact same reasons, too. That's the one that hurts.
Number two should actually get me scholarship.
It doesn't.
It's supposed to.
It doesn't. I hate to say that. It really does not. Statistically speaking, it goes the other way. I think they said 60-40. It goes towards the other way.
Oh, yeah. Okay. I'm smarter than those others.
That's not it. Smarts mean jack, unfortunately.
Apparently.
That's the thing that really, really sucks. And I am immensely grateful that I got the scholarships that I did in high school. Otherwise, I would not have been able to afford where I went.
Yeah, I get to have fun with signing up for college week after next. And I get to go talk to the program director and convince him that I'm smart enough to not have to take the beginner security class.
You can do it. I have faith in you.
I'd better, because otherwise I'm not taking that other class. I'm not going to take a beginner security class in the second half of this semester. That's ACON country.
I hate when they do that.
Well, see, there are two prereqs for this class. Mm. One is the beginner, the uber beginner, like 100 level class. And the other class I have already taken, the class I have taken supposedly has that beginner class as a prereq, mm-hmm. or a Cisco certification.
Yeah.
Which I have. So I would think that this is enough to prove that I don't need beginner security class because it also served as a prereq for the other class.
Mm-hmm.
I think I can get past beginner security. I'm pretty sure, given what I've taken.
I'm with you on that one. The one thing that I really, really hate is when they set up the classes where it's like, oh, you can take the beginners in the spring, and then you can take the advanced class in the fall. Wait, shouldn't it be beginner, fall, advanced, spring? Why do we flip-flop this? Why do we have that giant gap over the summer and force people to pay extra? Oh,
well,
you're forcing people to pay extra money, aren't you?
If they had beginner, spring, advanced, summer,
that would be fine. But
I could do that.
Most places don't do that.
But in this case, they're only offering the advanced class one time, which is at the beginning of the semester. And they're only offering the prereq one time in the second half of the semester. And you're not allowed to take them concurrently.
Nope.
So basically, I get one shot. And if it's not approved, then I'm just not going to take either class and take a break from school this semester.
Yeah, that's all you can
I only need one more class, realistically. And then I can just move on. Mm-hmm. I don't have to go to this particular college anymore, because I will have done everything I wanted to do.
Mm-hmm.
I really don't want to have to pay them any more money than I absolutely have to.
I know you don't. But they're also a business. They're in the business of making money.
No, it's a community college. They're really not making that much money. You know,
they have to make some money.
I would love to use that money for something else, like cosplay fabric for this uber secret cosplay we're doing, because that's going to cost me a boatload of money from what I looked at when I saw prices online. Oh my god.
Depends on where you were looking, and you've got me. I am the
I looked at Gold
shopper.
Door. Which, this would have to be on sale for me to even consider it. Oh my gosh. But still, you know, apparently next week when I get my final paycheck from my old job, it's going to have all of my accumulated stuff I'm getting paid for, which is my extra PTO and such.
Yeah.
It's like, okay, so that means at the beginning of next month, I can pay off my car.
Mm-hmm.
That means I have an extra $230 a month that I can use for stuff.
Yay, stuff.
Which is cosplay. I won't use all of it for cosplay. Obviously, I'm going to stash a great deal of it in investments, but
of
still,
course.
I have spare money I can actually use for cosplay stuff now, like heavy-duty cosplay stuff, plastics and power tools and fiberglassing.
Whereas me, I'd be like, ooh, I can afford the nice silk.
I don't like investing in extraordinarily expensive things for cosplay like that, consumables.
Mm-hmm.
Because I know that as soon as that cosplay wears out, if I can't wear it anymore, if something happens to it, I grow out of it and don't want it anymore, you know, what have you, I've basically used up that money, and I can't account for the fact I'm going to keep that cosplay forever, because I'm not. So I feel like I'm flushing money down the drain if I spend a boatload on a costume that I'm not going to keep for a long period of time. I would rather spend it investing in things that I know will last a long time, like power tools.
Mm-hmm.
And then maybe not quite spend so much on the fabrics and consumables, because I know those are going to disappear like within a couple of years. None of my costumes last as long as power tools will.
I can understand that. However, you've got me. And I know some really nice discount places where I can get some really good fabric for a lot cheaper than what we're used to paying for.
True. Plus, the only reason I would...
I have a lot of coupons. If there's this one site that I go to a lot, I have a lot of coupons that I've stored up recently. Yeah, we'll totally unleash them on our fabrics.
The only reason I even consider expensive fabrics is for the sheer fact that I enter them in competition. If I weren't,
yeah,
I wouldn't care. All it has to do is look like the character for me. It doesn't have to be uber accurate. It doesn't have to be, you know, uber particular with the fabrics that are being used. Yes, I know some fabrics look better than others. I'm aware of the properties of fabrics. I know all of this. I have taught much of this. But as somebody who's on a tight budget for a lot of the time as a college student, I'm not one to use money unnecessarily.
Mm-hmm.
So if I don't have to have that expensive fabric, generally I won't.
Yeah, and there's nothing wrong with that. I mean, I do it too. It's not like I have to be like, oh, this needs to be screen accurate to a T. I'm only going to do that if it's something that I know I'm going to enter into a contest. The only reason I'm spending so much money on making sure I get the nicer fabrics for Amidala is because it's going to be in a contest. I decided this many, many eons ago. So, I'm with you. I am on the same page as you. You just have to trust me that we will find nice fabrics and not break our wallets, I promise you. And especially since we're going to be dyeing some of this crap. So, you know, that's even better. We can get it white a lot cheaper.
If we win anything at the contest this year...
Oh, my God.
If we win anything, I'm retiring from competition. That will be it. That will be my trifecta. I will have won at the three big cons that I have attended. No more. I am done. I have my credentials. I can count myself as an award-winning cosplayer and teach. I'm good. It's all that matters. I don't even want to win the competitions for prestige. I just want to win it so that I have credibility in the cosplay community. I mean, I will never, ever be a Yaya Han or a Melfina or a sexy cosplay. I won't ever be like that. I won't ever be that famous. All I need is just enough credibility that I can teach and people will take my word for it.
I take your word for it. But again, you know,
I mean, the community at large.
You don't give yourself enough credit, lady.
Probably not.
You'd be surprised how many people use your tutorials for weapons and such. I mean, heck, I see so many people with the segmented staffs now, and it's like they had to have learned that from Amber, because I see exactly what they did, and it's like, Amber does it that way. It had to be from Amber.
Well, I'm not the first person that's come up with this.
I just happen to be the person that
does a tutorial on it.
You have a tutorial on it, and you have one of the better tutorials on it. Not many people have good tutorials.
Well, it's because
I
have a teacher background. So my tutorials are so good. My college degree was good for making cosplay tutorials. Yes! $80,000 later, And I have a music degree, and I make awesome tutorials.
Woo! Yay, teaching!
My music professors would probably have something to say about that. Well, to be fair, I also have a 10-year symphony, 10-year, not tenure, 10-year symphony career. So there is something to be said about that, too.
Yeah. I'm putting my video degree into great use.
Yes. Oh, incidentally, this is kind of cute and amusing, and we may do this for our next contest. I don't know yet. Since you prompted me to choose a cosplay name, because I don't have one.
Yeah, you don't have one.
I don't have, like, Velvet Rose cosplay or Twinsit cosplay. I don't have a cosplay name. Mm-hmm. If you want to ask about me in the community, I am simply Amber.
She's Amber.
Or Cospod Amber. Yeah, if people refer to me, it's just by my name. So I may end up having listeners submit ideas for cosplay name. And I can pick one for the contest winner. I'm not obligated to use it.
Okay.
I will pick one that I like.
Okay.
As the winner. And I may use it if it's a good one. I may not. I don't know.
That's funny. I like this.
But I think it would be kind of an amusing contest.
Yeah.
That I think people could get in on.
I like this. A $10 gift card? Yeah, why not?
Yeah. I mean, we are sponsored in our contest by Epic Cosplay. So it has to be an Epic Cosplay name.
Oh.
What?
You're way too white to be doing that.
Yes, I am rather pale. Thank you for noticing.
You're welcome.
So I'll type up a little something on our Facebook page so that people can see it publicly. I'll put a couple of things about me, the things I like, because, you know, that ends up coming into play in a cosplay name.
Sure.
I'll put a list of the cosplays I've done so people can get an idea of what it is that I like. And we'll see what they come up with. That'll be funny.
It'll be funny and fun and awesome.
So I guess we could probably start that now
and then go
through the end of the year.
Yeah.
So that way I could start the new year fresh with a cosplay name if I happen to choose one that I like.
Oh, man.
How about that? Does that work?
I like this a lot.
Oh, okay. Well, to close this off, we should probably explain why we're calling this episode Big Ass Gem.
Oh, hey, that might help, huh?
So, in the Beginner's Guide to Props and Armor, a lot of your submission doesn't count.
Dang! It's a good one.
A lot of the things they were mentioning about the armor they had built already were tips for putting gems or gem-like things, because there's a lot of domes and round things in anime armor. And one of the phrases they really liked to use was big-ass gem. And they were specifically referring to the art book versions of Magic Knight Rayearth armor. I want to say it was version 2 armor. It wasn't their final armor. But it was the art book version of their armor, and they had Easter eggs and Christmas ornaments, which are traditionally what cosplayers use when they need large domes.
I do them all the time.
For armor gems.
Anytime I have any type of gem on any of my staffs, even on my Sailor Mercury's collar, it always comes from Christmas ornaments.
Right, which, since the season is coming up, you may wish to stock up after Christmas on the clearance boxes of Christmas ornaments, because all you need is something that will cut glass or plastic, Dremel. You cut the ornament in half so that you have a dome, and that's what you put on your costume.
This is assuming, now that Hobby Lobby sells a bunch of these, and this is the ones I pick up, they actually have a set of Christmas ornaments that are already in two halves, and you just stuff them with stuff.
One.
Yeah, they're the plastic ones. They're two halves already. You just twist them together, or you untwist them. Those are the ones I use, so I only really need a half of them. I never really need the full size. So yeah, I get double the price of one.
Right. If you go the plastic route, that's probably the better way to go.
Oh, yeah.
If you end up, you know, needing something else and you have to go the glass route, be careful.
Be careful.
Those are glass, so as you're cutting them, wear the appropriate protections. The advantage to using the glass ornaments is that they come in different sizes.
Mm-hmm.
So you have more variety. Plus, they're already metallic if you get the gold and silver and red and blue and green, I think, are the colors that they use.
Yeah.
So you can get them, you know, pre-metallicized if that's what you want.
But painting the plastic ones is actually really simple.
It's not hard. I mean, you can spray paint them with the Krylon.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. So with that, we will bid you adieu. I am going to go try and find Doctor Who stuff now, because it's over.
It's over. It'll be okay.
It's okay. I can watch Saint Seiya. It's streaming in Japan now.
Yay! See, there you go. You're fine.
Yay! All right, so submit your cosplay names for me, guys, and keep them family-friendly, please, because these actually go up on our public website, so...
Warning noted!
Otherwise anything goes. All right. Bye, guys.
Bye, everybody.